Look, I mean, I'll say just one thing, purely from a risk reward point of view, because the market open is also the high, and you've had advanced decline at 9:1 to start with. I mean, if this market has to decline, perhaps this is the point. I mean, if it doesn't decline from here and again takes out the morning open high, then of course you will have a second wave of buying. But purely from a risk-reward point of view here, I think the market's given you first warning sign in terms of what's happening to the index, both the Nifty and the Bank Nifty, Sonia. So I think it's not worth chasing it unless you start to take out the open high pattern, which you have both on the Nifty and on the Bank Nifty. On the Bank Nifty future, open is the high. So let us see, because it's getting too euphoric now, and euphoric moves at times can have at least some shakeout. The market is vulnerable to a 200-300 point intraday Bank Nifty decline, 100 point intraday Nifty decline, which may not mean much in the larger context of things, but just not this kind of a market which you want to chase. But anyway, Ashwani, how would you trade the index today, if at all? Any trades here?
See, I have bought the 10,500 June put, and my sense is this sort of an open will probably see a decent dip, even if it continues later on the upside. But this is a nice point after a 6-day huge up move, plus some more upside today. Chances are we could be getting ready for some sort of a serious profit booking type of move, which could take the Nifty lower, maybe by like 100 points.
Okay, that's the call from Ashwani. Very quickly, Mitesh, any thoughts from your side?
Anuj, I already mentioned about taking profits on the index, but look at paint stocks. I think Asian Paints, Berger Paints, both have given early morning strong buy signals. I think those stocks could possibly be the highlight of the day.
Okay, gentlemen, thanks a lot for taking us to market opening. The Bank Nifty future is about to slip into the red, and same is the case with the Nifty future. So, like I said, perhaps if the market had to dip, that was the point. It will be interesting to see if this dip gets bought, because that's been the market's texture. But today, the market could be a bit vulnerable to at least take some money off before it has to start its climb once again. Mihir Vora is joining us, Director and Chief Investment Officer at Max Life Insurance. Mihir, good morning. Thanks a lot for joining us. Now, as a portfolio investor, what are you doing? Because there would be temptation to raise some cash levels, right, after the kind of one-way rally that we have seen in the broader market. But you tell us, what's your approach now?
Hi, good morning. I think you did mention that there is a bit of a euphoria coming in. So it's a tough one at this point in time. On one hand, you know the numbers and you know that things are still slow and there will be earnings downgrades. But on the other hand, you have this global wall of liquidity. And I think, as Sonia mentioned, you can't fight liquidity. So as a portfolio manager, it's a conundrum. It's a tough time to be in. Having said that, I don't think we have the great temptation to raise cash, because I think at least we were sitting on a bit of cash to start with. So to that extent, it's maybe hurt a bit. So that cash levels are still there. So I don't think we'll be booking aggressive profits. Maybe stocks-wise, where we think valuations are not really, in line with the positives or negatives, there we can think of it. But I don't think the way liquidity is coming in, we would take huge profits at this point in time.
Okay, you won't take profit. But are you entering, good morning, Mihir. Are you entering any of these so-called value zones? You know how much IDBI Bank has risen this month? 78%. This week, 14%. And today, 5%. I could go on like that. Bandhan Bank, I mean, it's not in the same category. It's a private bank and has had a good run already. But even that is up 65% this month and about 25% this week. That's Bandhan Bank. Let me keep Bandhan aside. Would you go into any of the public sector banks? Today is actually BOB's day.
In PSUs, we only have one name, the big one. I don't think we'll be adventurous yet, because because of the moratorium for the next 6 months, we will just have no clue as to how much of the final moratorium is going to turn into NPAs. And if you look at some of the relatively larger PSU banks, they have said that almost 60% of the book is under moratorium. So that's large, really large compared to the private sector, which is closer to 30%. So I don't think, given the fact that we are still in a slowdown, we still don't know the real situation of the moratorium book, we would not go into banks or NBFCs or any financial institution where there is a large amount of moratorium. So that uncertainty we are unable to deal with. Mm-hmm. And having said that, it's also the fact that even the bank, private sector banks in the Nifty, for example, which were beaten down, are still available at a little above 1.2 to 1.3 times price to book. So when you have the other, you know, relatively better moratorium books available at 1.5 times book, why go into, you know, something which is much more riskier?
Okay. Okay, what about the private banks? I mean, in the height of the, or rather during the trough days, people would only stick to the HDFC banks of the day, HDFC banks and the Kotak banks. But do you think the mid-cap banks, look at the way Bandhan has risen, the mid-cap banks, private banks are now coming back into the reckoning?
So some of them were beaten down in the mid-cap space because of exposure to certain segments, whether it was MFI or SME segment. Some of them were beaten down because of that. So with the rural economy coming back, maybe some of that oversold attitude has been corrected in some of these names. But in general, mid-cap banks do tend to have a bit more exposure to the SME segment. So that makes it a little more riskier, I would say. So we would, in the banking space, still prefer to stick with the larger banks, which are more diversified, retail plus corporate plus SME. So we get an overall exposure to the economy rather than a particular segment, which may turn out to be a bit worse than expected.
Okay, got that. Well, for now, the market is coming off a little bit from its highs. The high was 10,541. We are back at 10,517 or so. So a tad bit of a come off. Mihir, the space to be in this morning clearly seems to be paints. There is the consumption theme that's coming back. Even Kansai Nerolac yesterday told us that 100% of their stores are open. Asian Paints gross margins were good. Would you put fresh money to work in this sector?
Yes, because, you know, I think a lot of the plays in the last few days have been around the rural space. So, and if you look at the headlines, whether it's the unemployment number, the Manrega spend that is being rolled out, it does look like the rural economy, because of good monsoon and the extra, you know, money being put into the rural economy, is coming back a bit faster than the urban piece. So paints, rural housing, rural construction, the names linked with that theme may tend to do well.
Hmm. Okay, well, by the way, just, you know, to tell you the kind of market we are in right now, just look at Page Industries. After coming out with what looked like a horror set of numbers, that stock is one of the top gainers today. But that's market for you. Mihir, the space that's made a massive comeback is pharmaceuticals. The index itself is up 50% in the last 3 or 4 months. You know, do you reckon this is start of something big? Is this a bit of a turning point here? Or is the large move done now?
No, I think pharma is here to stay. A couple of points. One is the fact that there is a move clearly towards de-risking our, you know, pharmaceutical supply chain, which is basically linked to the China factor. And to that extent, there is a chance that, like the government did in the electronic space, there's a package for turnover linked, production linked, and investment linked, manufacturing of electronics in India. It's highly likely that some kind of scheme might be in the works for the pharma sector also, which means that you might see suddenly a lot of pharma companies going more backward into, you know, integration into intermediaries and APIs. So that's one theme. And second is the COVID spread is still, we must not forget, it's still on. We are increasing new cases in the world at a pace which was much higher than the previous months, though it's more spread out across more countries. But the rate of infection is still pretty high, and you will see illnesses needing pharmaceuticals. So I think the demand for pharmaceuticals in general will continue to remain robust. The fact that we have this need now, strategic need to diversify away from China, means that you might see a lot of pharmaceutical companies going into an expansion mode and a growth mode.
Okay. Mihir, what is your world view in terms of the way this liquidity may pan out? Liquidity can also disappear suddenly. So does that affect your choice of stocks? If yes, how?
Well, Latha, it's really a tough time to be a portfolio manager when you have money to invest and this kind of liquidity is chasing all asset classes, stocks, bonds, everything. You know, even gold is doing quite well. So to that extent, one can only look at the relative valuations of stocks and asset classes. And within that, there are still quite a few beaten down stocks which we are now focusing on. So I don't think, it's a wise call to say that the markets are overvalued and... Hello? Hello? Hello, am I audible?
Go ahead.
Go ahead, sir.
Yes, you are.
Go ahead.
Okay. So as I said, this kind of liquidity, it won't be a wise thing to say that, we are going to go short on the market or things.